So this is the drone that I ordered back on July 1st. And as you can see on the right here, that's the one I actually ordered, and it was a lot bigger than I thought it would be. It's not the drone that I got. The one that I got was substantially smaller, and they lost it. So let's dive into this. Okay, so we're going to have a bit of background noise, but this is the drone that I ordered off Instagram. And then this just arrived this morning. So we're going to see if this is the drones that we are looking for. Now, it looked very cool in the ads, but I'll tell you right now, the box feels completely lightweight. It doesn't feel like you see this picture here and you think, oh, that's a cool looking, good looking drone. But man, it feels like it's empty. It literally feels like this box is empty. So we shall crack it open really quick here and take a look. You'll see what I see when I see it as I see it. Oh my God, the box is probably, I swear that this foam is probably heavier than the whole damn drone. And when you look at it, it says, oh, a controller and a drone and a little GoPro camera. That's not the camera they showed in the ad. This whole thing is, I'm gonna guess, a shit box. And am I gonna be out $73 or whatever it came to in Canadian funds? Probably. What a messy setup. Okay, app user guide. Instructions. I'm already disappointed. Extra blades, propellers, charging cable, proprietary charging cable, I might add. That is not a USB cable. The remote weighs, oh my. Can you hear that? Is that the battery? I guess that's the battery. What a shit show. Drone. Please do not buy this on Instagram. Don't buy anything on Instagram. And here is the GoPro Hero 7 Black. As you can tell, quality craftsmanship. Look at this cool little, obviously authentic metal gimbal. What is this? That the antenna? All right, well, should I assemble it and try it and play with it and see what happens? All right, give me 2 minutes.
A few moments later.
Well, it already has more range than my Tello, but it's so lightweight that any wind just throws it all over the place. And I need to put the propeller guards on it.
Good luck bringing that guy back. Now look how high up it goes. Oh shit. Come on back. I lost it. There it goes. Way over there, now it's on the ground. Huh, how many pieces should it be in? 3, 4? Okay, let's try this again.
There's the camera, and right now it's recording, supposedly. So I'm gonna try this once more. It didn't take the damage too bad. I think we'll survive. Okay, let's see what the camera footage looks like.
It's running out of juice.
I can tell. I'll see how it's so slow.
Yeah.
I see the lights.
Yeah.
It's like I'm going for a walk.
So I lost it over there somewhere. So now I have to go find it.
I'll be right back, apparently.
Yeah, the battery must have died, so. At least we recovered it. That's all that matters. Okay, let's finish this video.
Wait a minute, Squeaky. How did he get there? How did he get there?
Let's do a quick weight test. This is in ounces. 3 ounces. Can you see that? 3 ounces. 85 grams. 85 grams, that's without the battery. The battery, with the charger, three point six ounces. That's so small, so light. Okay, so I have a couple pros and cons with this. Obviously, pro, it's under $100. You know, it's still much cheaper than, say, the Tello, which is like a DJI knockoff thing. The Tello has more intuitive controls. This thing is a toy. That's all it is. It is just a toy. And my things I guess that I was more upset about was the fact that it was advertised as like a drone this big instead of a drone this big. So yeah, I was a little bit ticked off about that. But it is what it is, and maybe I'll get my money back from PayPal or not, because I did file a not-as-described claim against this. But, and the camera's shit. Obviously, the camera's horrible. But I have a thought for that, actually. I was thinking of taking the camera off and actually replacing it with a, GoPro mount. Like, I might just take an actual GoPro mount, put it on there, and see if that makes any kind of difference or not. Why is this thing not coming off? Okay, so if I don't break it, so I could take that and maybe put like a GoPro mount on there. We'll have to see. Yeah, $50. I don't think it's worth it, personally. I mean, there's other things I could do with that money, like put it towards a used Mavic or something. Oh, and if it gets any kind of wind, it's gone. It's like out of here. It just takes off. So you can't fly it in any kind of windy day. So that means I've been holding on to it for roughly a week and a half, and I haven't been able to use it because it was windy outside, and this thing just takes off and goes. So yeah, not worth the money. This is supposed to go into the remote to hold your phone, but it's so flexible that my phone just pops out. It doesn't actually hold it like that. It kind of knocks it out, which I do not like either. That's supposed to go up here, right? Like this. To hold your phone. Geez, I don't even know what this thing is called. I don't even know what it's called. 2.4 gigahertz. Headless mode. Don't even know what that means. One key return. 360 something or other. Do not touch the aircraft while it's flying. Do not fly near obstacles. Okay. Long story short, it doesn't really look like that. I would not buy this. Save your money.
But I do appreciate you watching the video. If you do want to get this, I don't even know if I have a link for this down below, if I can leave a link, but see what you can do. That's it. Thanks for watching. If you like these kind of videos, leave a thumbs up. And if you don't like these kind of videos, leave a thumbs up. I'm easy either way. We shall talk again. Thanks for watching.